Hi everyone, my name is Mindaugas and I'm a product owner at Oxylabs. In this video, we'll answer commonly asked questions about how to choose the best proxy servers. We'll also discuss the legality of proxies, what is the fastest proxy type, and what proxies are good for. So, let's get started. Let's take a closer look at the main proxy types. First of all, proxies can be categorized by their access type. They can be either dedicated proxies or shared proxies. Shared proxies are used by multiple users simultaneously, meaning they will also be accessible to other users. This can make proxies slower and, more importantly, more likely to get blocked if other users are scraping the same websites as you are. Dedicated proxies are used only by one user. This proxy type is also known as a private proxy. Dedicated proxies provide a user with a complete anonymity and high overall performance level. The fact that only one client uses dedicated proxies, they are likely to have a better success rate. The most common proxy types that we discuss in this video are residential and data center proxies. The main difference between them is their origin. Residential proxies carry IP addresses that are provided by internet service providers with residential internet subscriptions. This is the reason why these proxies are almost unblockable. Everyone is recognizing them as legit retail users. However, residential proxies are usually more expensive and slower than data center proxies. Data center proxies are not affiliated with internet service providers and originate from secondary corporations like data centers and hosting providers. These proxies are hosted on powerful hardware such as dedicated servers, which means that data center proxies are usually faster and more reliable. In general, data center proxies are considered as the fastest proxy type. The downside is that since these IPs belong to B2B businesses and not residential ISPs, such proxies can be more easily identified and blocked. Before discussing how to choose the best proxies, we should take a closer look at what proxies are used for. Firstly, for regular internet users, a proxy could come in handy if there is a need to browse the internet more privately. If you want to hide yourself and your real IP address, using a proxy is the easiest way to do that. What's more, a proxy tied to a specific location can unlock geo-blocked content when your real IP address doesn't have the privilege to access this particular information. On a business level, the same factors come into play as discussed before. Externally, many businesses use proxies to carry out their day-to-day operations. The most popular use cases of proxies are market research, brand protection, cybersecurity operations, email protection, review monitoring, and travel fare aggregation. So, when choosing the best proxies, you should think of the most important part: what websites you are going to scrape and what data you want to extract. Also, if you already tried web scraping and know your target websites, you should consider what issues you had encountered in the past. If you need to scrape raw data or assets like images, it means that your average request size becomes quite large. Usually, residential proxies are charged for traffic, so it's important to consider your budget. In this case, we recommend choosing data center proxies since they have unlimited traffic. If you're not planning to scrape all the time and you need one-time data for your project, residential proxies should be a more cost-efficient choice. If you're searching for a solution to scrape real-time data, data center proxies are faster and more stable compared to residential proxies. However, they are easier to catch and block. If the response time is not that important, residential proxies are a better option. Most websites serve content according to the geolocation of visiting IP addresses. Some websites provide content to a single country, so if you're visiting from a website from another country, you will not get any data. In this case, residential proxies will do the best job for scraping data from such websites. Also, the legality of proxies and web scraping is a much debated topic among developers and others who work in the data gathering field. Proxies may be legal in cases where they are used without breaching any laws. Before engaging in any activity with proxies, you should get professional legal advice regarding your specific situation. I hope that this video has helped you to understand how to choose the best proxies that suit your needs best. You can learn more about how to choose the best proxy server by watching our data center proxies and residential proxies videos. Also, if you have any questions about proxies, contact us at hello@oxylabs.io or simply write a comment below. Thank you.